What's up, Cake Dream Nation? Beginning of a new week, and I want to start off with a movie I just rented, like, today. Monday, for all y'all seeing this now. It's called Tormented. It's a newer horror film that came out. It's actually really good. It's an independent movie. You can look up the trailer on YouTube. I hadn't heard of it until I saw it at Redbox. So if you guys use Redbox, make sure you guys check that out. Really good atmospheric horror film. It's a lower budget movie, but I think it was really well done for what they had. Very creepy movie, and not a lot of movies I can say that about, like, are genuinely, like, creepy in that aspect. So, yeah, if you guys haven't checked it out, make sure you guys check that out. You can find it at Redbox. It's not on Netflix yet. I say yet because it may turn up on Netflix in the not-too-distant future. So, yeah, and I think I'm going to do some test footage on our computer to see how the video recording does. So, if you guys were able to, I'm going to do some, maybe on Omegle, see if I can get some of Cake Drain Nation to come find me on there. I'm going to be going in as the Cold Jew. I'm going to put on the jacket and put on the mask and maybe the gloves and just kind of see who I can meet. I did that before. I haven't recorded it before. I've tried it in the past, but I never posted it. So I think it could be kind of fun. And I'll edit out anything that's inappropriate because that's what happens on Omegle. Sorry, on these kind of sites. But I will try to get some video as part of this vlog, maybe even earlier this week. You guys probably have seen it if I did. But, yeah, I'll put a tweet out so you guys can check it out and come find me. So, let's see how this goes. What's up, guys? Last time I tried this, it didn't work. So, I'm sorry that that's not on here, but the app seems to be working now on my computer, so I'm going to try to do another screen capture. I'm going to go on Omegle with my Dollmaker mask and see what people think. And I'm going to tweet out again, then I'm going to head out there, so maybe I'll catch some of Cake Drain Nation out there. So if y'all were on there, look for yourselves. Thing. As you guys saw, I was able to screen capture on Omegle, got some good reactions there. So I'm actually going to have a special interview coming up. Actually, I'm about to start one with a very special guest. This guy I haven't talked to in a long time. I've done an interview with him on the Daily Slither way back, and I think it's time for Cake Drain Nation to get a little more of an update. And he's been on
he has been on a few episodes of I Just Woke Up. He hasn't been on the Cake Drain show yet, but hopefully we'll get him on in the future to do a full Cake Drain interview. All right, guys, let's check out this interview.
All right, you guys, here is my very special interview I promised you guys. All the way from way up north in Red Deer, Alberta, Cake Drain's favorite Canadian, D-Rock. How's it going, D-Rock?
Not too bad. How you doing?
Doing pretty good. So we've been talking a little bit over messaging and stuff, and you've been telling me about some of the stuff that you're planning for Wrestling Talk 1 and some of the updates that you've been able to do. Could you let us know a bit, like, what's all going on for, like, Wrestling Talk and, like, the you post on Twitter about, like, the job you're able to do. So you want to help us out with that?
Yeah, so what's actually going on? I'm not sure, not everybody's going to be on my Facebook, so they probably did not get the memo.
Yeah.
This past Saturday, I had a tryout for a wrestling. And so right now with Wrestling Talk and at the Real D-Rock 1 YouTube channel, that's pretty much on hold right now. But I am waiting for the footage of my debut. So it's going to be on Wrestling Talk, some of the highlights of the event and all that. I'm just waiting for someone else who's a video editor. Mm-hmm. So I've been busy training, so to get on the next Wrestling Talk is going to be kind of hard, but I'm going to be trying to get some of my co-workers in from the wrestling organization to get them on YouTube on Wrestling Talk, and also I'm going to be blogging about my process of training.
Nice, that'd be really cool. I don't know, I didn't post on this channel, but I have posted vlogs about my wrestling training, just kind of, I posted on Facebook a lot because I didn't have my channel at the time, but, you know, it is really tough. If you guys out there haven't, are you kind of judgmental about wrestlers, like, oh, they're not really athletes, go to a wrestling camp for a day, like, see if you can get just a day of... See if you can talk to a promoter or talk to a guy who runs a wrestling school. Get a day of wrestling training. You will find out this is the toughest thing you'll ever do, unless you're, like, in the military.
Yeah, there should be wrestling camps in close to your location. If not, then you do what Drake did. You go find someone, like, a state over or whatever, and you basically start training. Like, I am basically, like, you guys can't see it now, but before I had this big goose egg and a nice scar, so... Yeah, it's not as easy as it looks.
Yeah, it's really intense. And you told me that you were able to take a bump into a, like, turnbuckle from getting hit.
Yes, what happened was, I was playing, right now I'm a security guard, first and foremost, but I'd be training as a referee. So what happened was, this past Saturday, with this wrestling event, I was breaking up a fight from a wrestler trying to beat up on a referee, and then I got in the ring trying to save the ref, and the guy, his name for short, his wrestling name is Mono, very big guy, and I tried to save this ref from Mono, and yes, basically got tossed in the turnbuckle and was feeding punches like nonstop.
Yeah, and for those, let me switch camera. For those of you who don't know, turnbuckles aren't, they are padded, but there's impact. They still have a lot of impact behind them. It's a metal ring that's covered by, like, a very thin cushion and a piece of fabric, and you hit that full speed. It hurts. Nobody can tell you. You just accept the fact it hurts. You don't get used to it. It just hurts. So.
Yeah, I do have a turnbuckle in my room, but I will put that on Wesley Talk and talk about the turnbuckle. And
nice.
So, I think that should be a good little piece of wrestling talk, yeah, like a conversation.
Yeah. So, another thing I wanted to talk to you about was we recently had our Dub Smash battle, which actually was really good. You know, thank you guys, everybody, for your votes. I was really, surprised in a good way. It went really well. Do you have a favorite, like, Dub Smash that either you did or I did or either one of us did that was pretty close?
I think the one I liked was my first dubstep for that one was It's Monday. Do you remember that? It's
I think, yeah, Monday. Yeah.
Yeah. Because it started out on a Monday and then ended on a Friday, I think.
Yeah, it was Monday through Friday, and then Saturday we announced it.
And then I had my profile pick chose by the winner, which was Drake.
Yeah, I have to say, I really had to fight the urge to like some of your videos, because I didn't want to, you know, be like, his is better than mine. But it was a lot of fun, because it got interaction from both of us on our channels, but also it kind of, you know, got us both a bit to have fun, you know, something different for our channels. And a lot of interaction from people. I mean, at the end, it got super, I think I won by like 5 votes. At the end of it, it was really super close. So once again, thank everybody for your votes on that.
Most of my votes were from my coworkers and some people who actually saw it. So not a lot of people really cared about it, but yeah.
Yeah, the ones I got were like family, friends back in New Mexico, or people. You know, they were like, "How do I vote? How do I get a part of this?" So people were excited about it, which, you know, surprised me. But it was a lot of fun to do. Hopefully we can do some more stuff like that in the future, some more collaboration type stuff.
I'm hoping to do this more in the, like, kind of a once-a-year thing, kind of make it an annual thing.
Oh, that would be awesome. Kind of a, you know, war to settle the score, Dove Smash.
Yeah. Kind of like a WrestleMania, you know?
Dove Smash Mania. I don't think. What do you guys think? Post in the comments. Maybe a little Dove Smash rematch. What do you think? Let us know. Sorry, I keep switching back and forth between my camera. But, you know, that's, you know, what I love about us as a group of, as Cake Drain, because Kane was down the middle. Like, he was kind of the...
He was pretty good. He was fair. He was basically...
He was very fair. He basically, like, commented on both of ours, like, dude, you got to pick it up. This guy's kicking your butt. I'm like, I'm trying, dude. But,
Well, he actually, I listened to me one time, and he said, you know, you did good at this for today's, but I think the next one you would need to step your game up.
Yeah, he did the same thing for both of us, which is cool. As a Cake Drain family, we're able to work together on that kind of thing. You know, it wasn't like, I'm going to beat Derek and it's nothing else. You know, it's like we had fun. You know, we supported each other. Like I said, I wanted to like a lot of the dub smashes you did.
Yeah, exactly.
So... before we head out, is there anything else you'd like to let Cake Drain Nation know about either one of your channels coming up, or?
Okay, like Drake has commented, and I have commented. I have two channels. The first channel I'd actually really like to promote because it needs more subscribers is at the Real DRock 1 YouTube channel. It's capital T H E, capital R E A L, capital D. _rock1.
And I'll
that's
make sure.
My first. That's basically where I talk about anything as I please. There won't be any wrestling for. So for you non-wrestling fans, that's the channel for you. And my second channel is Wrestling Talk 1. Like I said, I'm going to be posting some extra stuff there, bonuses, basically blogging about my wrestling training progress. That's where I talk about wrestling, topics underneath the sun of pro wrestling. So, yeah, for anybody that's interested or wants to know more about wrestling, that'll be the channel for you, and it's Wrestling Talk 1, and that's all in one word.
Alright guys, I hope you, thanks Derek for, doing this interview. It was super fun to talk to you. Hopefully we can get you on the Cake Drain Show soon.
Oh yeah, for sure. Well, hopefully I'll be planning to do, personal appearance sometime in the next New Year's, but yeah, that's down the road.
That'd be awesome. Yeah, so check out I'm gonna switch the camera around. Make sure you check out both our Twitters, at the Real DRock 1 for Derek, and of course Drake True Snake for mine, and all of Cake Drain. We would love to hear your input on everything we've done, and you know, give DRock a shout out because we love you, bro.
Yeah.
So
exactly, the Can-Am connection is what we are.
Can-Am Connection.
Canada and America.
The Can-Am Connection. Can-Am Cake Drain Connection. See, that's awesome. It's like a tag team coming together. It's like an 80s stable back when, you know, wrestling was awesome. So,
yes.
Sorry, I'm a nerd. So, all right, Derek. Thanks for taking time to
talk to Kick Drain Nation for a bit. Hope to talk to you later on.
Yep, you too, man. Have a good one.
You too. Bye. All right, guys. Time for the big unveiling, the big announcement you see on Facebook and Twitter. We have a couch! Oh, it's awesome. And, so comfy. This is our new couch that we got for free. So, story behind it, we actually got this out of the dumpster of our apartment complex. A lot of work. Some guys were moving out, and they just tossed it. So we found it and cleaned it, and it's ours. So the cool thing is it's a sleeper. So if we do have guests over, it's a cool, like our living room will become our guest room. Pretty cool, right? Yeah, I just want to show you guys the final unveiling of our new sofa. Oh, it's so relaxing. But yeah, let me know what you think in the comments about it, because I love this thing. Blessings from heaven. All right, you guys. The first day of October. First night of October. And we just watched our first Halloween movie, Hocus Pocus. So it has officially begun. I don't think we're going to be doing Cake Drain History Month this year, even though we will be celebrating Halloween, of course. Keep an eye out. The Cake Drain Show should be up now. I'll post the link in the description for when it should be up, or the link when it's up. But yeah, so Katrina, are you excited about October now that we've seen Hocus Pocus?
I'm very excited. Pumpkin everything.
Pumpkin everything. You know what I thought of today? But it might be too good for you, maybe too creative.
What?
Or maybe just too overload. Pumpkin spice apple cider. Because that's always the debate. No, I just thought about it, like, earlier.
Oh.
Because I was looking on Facebook, and, like, somebody shared about, like, dear pumpkin spice lovers, you're doing it wrong. Or it's not all about you. Love apple cider. I'm like, what about pumpkin spice apple cider? I think the world would implode at all that awesomeness. But, yeah. Happy October, everybody. So I will probably end the week here. It's a great ending of the week. But I will talk to you guys next week. We have more Cake Drain stuff coming your way. I'm excited. Hope you guys are. I'll talk to you guys then. Peace out. And remember, Bruce!